one of the major problems that we have as a society is our built environment is aging. Obviously, we don't want to demolish and rebuild all of our existing infrastructure. We'd rather come up with innovative ways to strengthen them and bring them up back up to an acceptable level of performance. And so what we're doing here today is we're testing reinforced concrete diaphragms, specifically looking at retrofit techniques to strengthen them in shear. Engineers are using fiber reinforced polymer retrofits on slabs such as the ones we're testing to bring their shear capacity up to where it needs to be. Unfortunately though, there's no tests to demonstrate the performance of the retrofits that they're using. And so the project that we're looking at is to come up with design guidance for practitioners to be able to confidently use fiber reinforced polymer strengthening on diaphragms. So a building is extremely large. Obviously, even though we have a big structures lab, we can't test a full-size building. So what we've done is we've extracted a critical piece of a slab. And the idea is, much like an earthquake, we're gonna load that slab back and forth in reverse cyclic loading, subjecting it to progressively larger and larger displacements or larger loads until it fails. And in doing so, in testing it up until failure, we'll be able to understand what kinds of cracks, how big are the cracks going to be in the diaphragm, how does the steel perform in the existing slab, how does the FRP perform, and then ultimately we'll understand how the FRP fails. Sheet one on this side is debonded maybe a fifth of the way and the anchor's still holding.
Working here gives you a lot of hands-on experience, you know. You're sitting in your office and you're designing something, but then you got to come out here and build it. So I think that's the biggest takeaway for me. As engineers, we don't tend to think about how this is gonna get built. It's more as, are the calcs gonna work and can I draw it on CAD? You're never thinking about the guy in the field building.
If I was a prospective student in the Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering at Virginia Tech, I would consider that our faculty are solving real world problems. We are at the forefront of civil and environmental engineering science and our students are leading that charge. Through collaborations of faculty and students working together along with their sponsors and various partners in industry and government, we are addressing some of the biggest challenges at the intersection of the built and natural environment.